Hello everyone, as we know our school residential Gurukul is providing all the video lecture through our YouTube channel, through our WhatsApp group or on our Facebook page. So related to that, today I came with a class 10th science chapter. The name of this chapter is Chemical Reaction and Equation, and this is the fourth lecture of this chapter. In last class we have discussed about the different types of reaction like combination reaction, displacement reaction, double displacement reaction and decomposition reaction. Today I came with a new type of reaction, that is oxidation reaction. First we have to understand what is oxidation reaction. Oxidation means when oxygen is combining together, or removal of hydrogen from any compound, or loss of electron. If these three things is happening, first one is combination of the oxygen, second one is removal of hydrogen, and third one is a loss of electron. If these three things is happening in any compound, with any compound or in a chemical reaction, at that time we can say this reaction is a type of a oxidation reaction. We will take one example. Copper, here copper is combining with oxygen and it's forming copper oxide. Here this copper is combining with this oxygen and it's formed copper oxide. So we can say that this copper is oxidizing. This copper is oxidizing with this oxygen and forms copper oxide. So we can say this copper is oxidizing here. So that in this, when this reaction is happening, you know, there, when this copper oxide form, the a gray color, black gray color coat will form on our vessels. Actually, the when we use the vessel of copper, we are seeing after a long time, we are seeing there is a gray color layer is forming on the vessel. Why? Due to this reactions. Now the next reaction is the reduction reaction. Reduction reaction, we can say it's just opposite of the oxidation reaction. So the definition of the reduction is that addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen, or gain of electron. If these three things is happening, first one is if in any reaction the addition of hydrogen is happening, or loss of oxygen is happening, or losses of oxygen is happening, or gain of electron is happening in any reaction, at that time we can say that this reaction is an example of a reduction reaction. Here I am taking an example when copper oxide combined with hydrogen and it form copper plus H2O. Here we see this, in this copper oxide, oxygen is removing from here. Oxygen is removing from here, this from this copper, and combining with this hydrogen. So we can say that this copper oxide is reducing here in the form of a copper. The next one is redox reaction. What is a redox reaction is that when oxidation and reduction take place together, when these two reactions take place together, this is example of a redox reaction. This reaction is called as redox reaction. See all the this type of example, all the oxidation reaction or all the reduction reaction is not a redox reaction. When these two things will happening in a reaction together, then only we can say that the example, this is example of a redox reaction. Like here we will take one example, when copper oxide react with hydrogen, same example we are explaining here. When copper oxide is combined with hydrogen and form copper plus H2O. So we know from the definition of the oxidation. Oxidation means combining with oxygen. So see from here, in the hydrogen, in this hydrogen is combining with oxygen. So this is example of oxidation. And from this copper oxide, oxygen is removing from here. So oxygen is removing and it's forming copper. It means this is an example for the reduction. It means in one reaction, oxidation is also happening and reduction is also happening together. So this is an example of a redox reaction. The next one example is that, see here, when zinc oxide react with carbon, it's form Zn and CO. It will form Zn and CO. In this reaction, when ZnO react with carbon, it forms zinc plus carbon monoxide, that is CO. Here in from ZnO, oxygen is removing. It means this is an example of the reduction reaction. And from the carbon is combining with oxygen. So this is the example of a oxidation reaction. Here carbon is combining with oxygen, that's why it's an example of oxidation reaction. and from ZnO here oxygen is removing from the compound, so it's example of the reduction reaction. When these two is performing together, this is also example of a redox reaction. So see here, this carbon, what is the role of this carbon here? Due to the presence of this carbon is attracting the oxygen to itself. Here from ZnO, this carbon is doing what? This carbon is removing, this carbon is an agent, he is removing the oxygen from ZnO or from any compound and combined together with that oxygen and forms carbon monoxide. Due to this reaction, due to this type of tendency, carbon is known as a reducing agent. Reducing agent means oxidize itself, when any agent oxidize itself and reduce to other one. Here carbon is oxidizing itself, but carbon is reducing that ZnO. So this carbon is example of a reducing agents. So there is a lots of effect are there in our daily life, like oxidation and reduction. So the first example of the this one for oxidation is corrosion, like when iron, our iron rod or some other things is corrosion and it form rust, that is not useful for us. So what is happening there? When iron is directly combined with the oxygen and with the water vapor, so it convert into Fe2O3. This is also example of oxidation reaction, and that's why the iron comes convert into rust. The other example is also that rancidity. When we are feeling that acidity in our stomach, that is also example of the oxidation reaction only, because when any food, fats or vitamins is reacting with oxygen, it convert into, it oxidize, and that's why the smell of that thing is also change. And to prevent from that, like some food is wasting, if food oxidize, then what will happen is the bad smell will come from there. So to prevent from that, we are putting some anti-acid. Anti-acid means that which stop this oxidizing agent, and that's why it's called as anti-acid. So when will we put that? So it stop that oxidation reactions. So that's all about the this chapter. In the next lecture, we will see the different things. Thank you.